I'll be talking about the sizes of storage devices. So I'll be talking about the capacity of each storage devices and the sizes of file sizes. So the file sizes are 8 bits equal to 1 byte or 1 B. 1024 bytes is equal to 1 KB or 1 kilobyte. 1024 kilobytes is equal to 1 megabyte or MB. 1024 megabytes is equal to 1 gigabyte or GB. And 1024 gigabytes equals to 1 terabyte. So the storage devices and their capacity. So the DVD is 700 megabytes. The DVD is 4.7 to 8.4 gigabytes. DVD RAM is 4.7 or 9.4 gigabytes. Blu-ray is about 25 or 50 gigabytes. Pen drive is about 2 to 64 GB, or more than that is 128 GB. The portable disk drive is about 320 GB to 4 terabytes. Solid state drive is about 100 to 500 MB. Hard disk drive is about 1 to 4 terabytes. Magnetic stripe is 500 GB to 5 terabytes.
Everybody, I'll be talking about data backup in this video. So, okay, data backup. So this is the introduction. So, those of you who are wondering what data backup means, data backup means making an extra copy of a piece of data from a computer that is in your computer. For example, if the computer you're using breaks, you still have an extra copy that you backed up, so you don't have to recreate the piece of data. Okay. Things you should back up. Well, the things you should back up are files that are important to you or files that you can't get back, such as a personal document, photographs, video, and you get the idea. However, you shouldn't back up programming files or operating system because they can be reinstalled on your computer. But there's another reason, and that reason is because since those files with those like operating system files will take lots of space in your backup storage device, so I wouldn't recommend you to do that unless you really have to. Reason you should backup: if you have a file that is important or some file you have to hand in to your boss or teacher, whatever, and then your computer breaks and the memory is damaged and you can't get the file back, you either have to recreate or you could get the backup version, and don't waste time recreating it. And I'll be showing you that things you could use to backup. Like, so for large files you could use a WD Passport Ultra, like the one seen on screen right now, and you could use a USB stick if it's like small files and you didn't get the idea. And you could use SSD, which you could store solid state drive, which you could store like more information than the USB but less than the portable hard disk.
Considerations we should make before choosing a storage device. What is a storage device? A storage device is any computing hardware that is used for storing, porting, and extracting data files and objects. It can store information both temporarily and permanently, and can be external or internal to a computer. A storage device may also be known as a storage medium or storage media. Types of storage devices. There are two types of storage device: primary storage device, which are generally smaller in size, and they have the fastest access speed, and they include RAM and cache memory. And secondary storage devices, they usually have a large storage capacity and they store data permanently. They can be both internal and external to the computer, and they include hard disk, compact disk drive, and USB storage device. device. What you should consider while choosing your storage device. Firstly, you should consider the cost. To be cost effective for a company, the price of online storage must be lower than the cost on-site tape or DVD backups or dedicated backup server. You can expect to pay between $0.15 and $0.5 per gigabyte per month. Second, you should consider the uptime. It is not pleasant when you can't get backup or you decide what it is you need to look for.